We're here for, I'm having a pastor's conference on Friday, and I have over 300 pastors and leaders coming in town. They're coming as far as London, Bermuda, Nassau, Bahamas, North Carolina, and other locations. And I'm bringing in my whole leadership team to gut ourselves and to give away what we do. Amen. How many of y'all know that it's a blessing to be a blessing? I want you to get your Bibles as we do this series on flashback. We go back to things that we used to watch on television. We didn't have reality TV. We had real actors and actresses. And I'm gonna see if you remember this show right here. Said, I need you to do me a favor and let this young man in. neither one of my parents had ever left home, never went to college. My mother, my father, neither my stepfather. And he called Alabama State, and I boxed up everything. They took me to Greyhound, sent me to Birmingham, where my stepfather's brother was. He picked me up at the bus station and then drove me to Montgomery. Not like now, you know, y'all have like going away parties and y'all bring the whole family down. They was standing outside Greyhound. Like, so I get down there and I didn't know anything. Because remember, it's not an educated house that I grew up in. My parents couldn't help me with my homework. They just didn't get it done. They didn't know, you know, so when I get down there, I didn't even know I was going to a black college. I got down there, I was like, what is all these black people doing down here? So I just shut up, you know, you just shut up and watch. And find out it's an HBC, some lessons. There's nobody to wake you up. You get up and go to class if you want to go. There's nobody to tell you to come in the house. You come in if you want to come in. There's nobody to stop you from getting into things that you don't have any business getting into. Now is when discipline comes in. So I learned some valuable lessons. I knew nothing about, you know, the educational system, knew nothing about a bachelor's degree. I knew nothing. You know, first time I heard somebody say, Dr. Lawson, I was like, why is a medical doctor in this class? This medical doctor to teach this English class.
I did the same thing. I didn't understand it either.
I knew nothing about black fraternities and sororities. I knew nothing. So when I started coming out stepping, I was like, what are they stepping for? Knew nothing. But I was open. I was open, and coming into Alabama State, it introduced me to a whole other world. I knew nothing about being around educated blacks or blacks that had money. You know, when you go to a black college, they'll invite you over, teachers invite you over to their house to eat. They literally adopt you. You know, and then I pull up at Dr. Lawson's house, I'm like, ain't nobody told me nothing. We living like this. They set the table, everybody sitting at the table eating. I'm like, what's really going on? It's a different world. And guess what? It's the same way when you come from the world to Christ.
Talk, preacher.
It's a transition. Based on how long you've been in the world, the transition might not be that easy.
Come on, preacher.
So the hardest thing is to do is to compare yourself to somebody who wasn't as deep in as you were. Y'all better say amen. Some
amen.
Of y'all was deep. You only look this good since he cleaned you up. Some of y'all need to go back and look at some of your old pictures. Your old pictures tell you how deep you were. Remember that lounge picture you took? Can you believe some of the stuff you used to wear? But then when you leave that world, or he calls you out of that world, or he picks you, pulls you out of that world. Look at me. It ain't no problem. And the Bible makes it real clear. Look at 2 Corinthians 5 and 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Here's the line that's a challenge. Old things, old behavior, is passed away. And behold, all things are become new. He literally calls you out of the old and into the new. So I had them to bring this fist because, you know, this could be your old side. And then this is like, he pulls you into this new side. Some of us struggle. I'm trying to stay over here on this new side, but and then the hardest part is to find somebody who know what it is to struggle between the two. Because church is so full of hypocrites that we want you to think that every day we over here talking, hallelujah, no, every day I'm not over here. I try to stay over here every day, but based upon how bad somebody get on my nerve, I have a tendency sometimes just to come in over here, I'll pump off, but then I'm going to come on back. Is there anybody in the building that can relate to what I'm talking about? It's a fight every day. So like on one side, you know, you walk in fear. And then the other side, you have to be fearless. You know, fear can cripple you. I've only had two incidents in my life that fear got the best of me. And when I get real fearful, this is a mess. My knees can shake and I can't walk. Fear cripples you. And some of y'all have allowed fear to cripple you at the job that you have or in the lifestyle that you're in. But we're not crippled. We will walk in the light as he is in the light. And God has not given us a spirit of fear. And the enemy want to hold some of you up down. But today is about to be, you're about to be delivered from. Jesus is like Jesus is teaching. And he goes to his own hometown and he teaches. And they don't like what he's saying. And they get mad. And you got to be careful because sometimes it appears like God let the enemy put his hands on you. Like he's controlling the situation. And when it looks like the enemy's controlling it and that you have no options, if you're not careful, you'll submit to the enemy. But the devil is alive. And there's somebody in the building, you might feel as if, well, I don't have that much education, I don't have that much experience, but we walk by faith and not by sight. And there's somebody in the building that God literally is about to deliver you from the spirit of fear. Do me a favor, touch your neighbor, say your ladder will be greater. Says that after Jesus got done teaching, they got mad. And look at the screen in Luke 4:28. The Bible says that all the people in the synagogue were furious when they heard this. Look what they did. Look at the verse. They got up. They drove him out of the town, took him to the road, the hill of which the town was built, in order to throw him down off the cliff. Watch what he did. The enemy cannot hit a moving target. And when it looked like the enemy got you, the Bible says, look, that's what he did. He walked right through the crowd and went on his way. How do you get this close to being thrown over, but he doesn't allow the enemy to throw you? Because what you have to do is get in your mind, the devil is alive. I'm not going out like this. And they say, anybody in the building, do you believe God? Listen, guys, God gave us a word. He said, within 52 days, if you work towards it, I'll bring a change. Which means that by August the 30th, many of us are going to see ourselves walking in another direction. I just need to bind fear off of some of you all. Because the enemy, it looks like he got you. But the devil doesn't control your destiny. Touch your neighbor and say, I need you to keep it moving. You can't get crippled. You can't let your knees buckle and say, this is the only way I'm going to live. The devil is a lie. You can't give in the bills. You can't give in the sickness. You got to learn, in spite of what the doctors say, I have a responsibility to keep it. I'm not just talking about walking. I'm talking about praise too. You can't let the devil shut you down and cripple you that you can't give God any glory. You must learn how to bless the Lord at all. Touch your neighbor and say, I dare you to praise God with me right here. Come on, get them chains off them. I dare you to open your mouth and give God glory. I dare you to magnify God right here. If you believe that your ladder is going to be greater, I dare you to open your mouth and bless the Lord right. Clap your hands and say, things are changing as of today. Yo, over here, you're fragile. Over here, you're fragile. But over here, you gotta walk in authority. And I'm amazed at how many Christians, you walk around like you have no power or no authority. He said, behold, I give you power. How does he give you power, but you don't exercise it? Y'all not believing me. See, like, come on, come on. You ready? I want you to get this. When you have power, when you have power, things hit that you didn't see coming. When something hits you unexpectedly, your whole equilibrium is thrown off. You start having panic attacks, you start losing your mind. You know, you get people in the world get fired, they're like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? Touch your neighbor and say, that is not us. You come home one day and you catch your kids doing something, you know you raised them better than that. You come home one day and your whole house, because no, one day you can get up, go to bed, and things are good, the next day your whole world can change. It can change just like that. And that is a true test of your faith. See, it's easy to do all this talking, but when that real thing hit, oh, y'all ain't ready for me today. Now, some of y'all do a whole lot of talking. It's easy to talk smack when you ain't going through nothing. But oh, when that devil hit, that's when we're going to see where your faith is right there. Anybody in the building know what I'm talking about? It's easy to get that door as long as you got money in the bank. I dare you to lose your job and you don't know where your, how your rent going to be paid. I dare you to go to your refrigerator and not have anything to eat. I dare you to have bill collectors calling. I dare you to go to the doctor say, I think I see something. There's something about we have to be firm. Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. Firm. What do you mean? Not shaken.
Not shaken. Oh, thank you, Lord.
On this side, literally, look at me. For real, we really do walk by faith. Yes. If we look at the facts, we crumble. Yes. But those of us that are people of faith, facts don't matter. Because I still believe that God got time. Now, let me show you how we do it. Let me show you how we deal with it. So, you got to get this. There's a storm hit the boat. Unexpected. A storm hit the boat. The disciples who've been following Jesus, just like many of us, start going crazy. Ah! They run in the back of the boat. Jesus is handling a storm. And this is the only time in Scripture that the Bible shows us that he sleeps. Isn't it amazing that the scripture would show you that he is asleep during a storm? Storms are not sent to keep you awake. I'm coming through here today. I'm coming through here today. Storms are not sent to have you to walk the floor and worry about it. But Jesus is showing you that if you just go ahead and go to sleep, because guess what? I did bring you this far to let you. I got somebody right now. The enemy trying to take your sleep, but the devil is a liar. Touch your neighbor and say, we about to get this thing today. We about to. Come on, come on, come on. I'm so sick of this devil. He in the back sleep. And then you gotta know how the devil is a punk. Notice. He doesn't come. Look, the first time they had a storm, he went on the boat. The second time, you're going to bring a storm while he's asleep. And some of y'all, you got to know how the enemy try to get you when you're either absent or you're at your weakest moment. Uh-huh. That's like some of y'all, you fight in your sleep. Because that punk, no, he can't get you when you're wide awake. Because if he gets you when you're wide awake, you got something to tell us behind. Ain't nobody. You need to wake your behind up. That's how they talk to you. Don't you care that we die? Carest thou not that we perish? English version. Look here, bro. we got it. Ain't that something? Ain't that how we talk? I ain't got nothing. Love and losing everything. Touch your neighbor and say, shut your mouth. It's sweet to your situation. Watch firm. He got up. He never addressed the disciples. The Bible says he rebuked what? He rebuked the wind and said not to the people. He said to the wind, quiet! Exclamation point. Be still! Exclamation point. Not a question mark. Exclamation point. Don't speak to people. Speak to the situation. And if you speak to the situation, that's a different world. That is a different world. We so used to addressing people when you need to address the spirit behind the person. No panic. See, over here we free. Over here, we chill. And we speak to the situation. Money coming. Money coming to me right now in Jesus' name. By his stripes, I am healed. He whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Point. I'm not asking you, I'm commanding you that you will give God glory at 8:20. Ain't nobody saying that to me. I decree and declare that everybody in my section will get a breakthrough before we leave. I need your mouth to open. Come on, y'all. Speak to the glory. Look down your road and say, everybody, give God glory right now. Come on, your neighbor, say, speak to it, not to them.
Come on.
Come on here, y'all. I'm trying to help somebody.
Come on.
I need you to tell somebody, say, speak to it, not to them. Speak to your mountain. And when you speak, you can't speak like you know punk. Bring the scripture in Psalms 28 and 1. Look what the Bible said. The righteous are as bold as a lion. And when you speak, I need you to speak with authority. Some of y'all, the enemy ain't paying you no attention because you're like, oh, never leave me alone. My money coming. My money coming to me. He can't even hear you. You gotta open your mouth and shout. You gotta, and I mean, when you say it, you gotta say it like you ain't got a care in the world. Some of y'all, I need you to believe that August, September, October, November, December gonna be better than January, February, March, April, May, June, or July. I need you to open your mouth, and then I need you to put a praise on. I gotta hurry up. But I need you to decree and declare that the latter part of this year is gonna be better than the beginning part of this year. God, I wish I could get somebody to speak that thing. Come on, here, speak to the spirit man. He said, prophesy to the wicked. Speak to what you can't see. Yeah, I gotta pray. So one is action, and then one is your verbal. And then the third thing, in the world, you just give in. Whatever your flesh wants, you just let your flesh have. I gotta move real fast. It's 8:23. Whatever you want to eat, you eat. Whatever you want to drink, you drink. You can take as many shots of Patron. You can just drink. Vodka, Coke. You can put some ice on it. On the rocks, you can have Long Island iced tea. For those of y'all that are not real drinkers, you drink the strawberry daiquiris because they taste like zombies. You ain't no hard drinker. You just want to feel a buzz. I just need the buzz. On the world side, you smoke, you drink, you sleep with whoever you want to sleep with. Hey, we grown, man. You know what? I'm horny, you horny, we horny. Let's get this over with.
Oh, shut up. Great job.
Ain't no relationship. You know, I don't even know your name. You know, but just we want to.
Slow up, brother.
We ain't looking for no relationship, but hey, all right? Come on, let you know you. That's over here. But then over here, he said, that don't go with this. And the hardest part is that if you've been living over here for years, and then you just got over here, and over there keep calling you. Don't look deep on me. I'll hit you in the head with this microphone. Don't look like you sanctified. Don't look like you Jesus' brother. How many of y'all know, if you've been over here for years, and then you come over here, he's like, don't drink that. Don't drink. Because you come over here, but then your body begin to crave what has been happening. Y'all ain't going to be honest. See, that's like I don't like talking to y'all. Your body begin to crave what you've been feeding it. You know, over here, you can't pop off. Over here, you let it run.
Not me.
Peter, like, hold on now. You just ain't gonna just come walking up in here. And look, this is a fight. Y'all ain't used to church folks talking like this. Cause you think we over here all day, shout that in, then you're like, oh, shut down. When I get done, shout out, that's why because if I don't I'm gonna stay over here. Y'all ain't. Every day. And I've been saying that 30 some years. I have not let him ride. But I have gotten mad in these last 2 years at a couple of people. That some words came back to me. Oh, my shit. Some words came back to my remembrance. And I was about to let it.
Come on, preacher.
Over here, you know what I'm saying? When I was over here, look, when I was over here, I used to, like, I practice smoking. You know you're good when you hold. Your old way, and you can look at them and say, listen, I know I'm not perfect, But if I don't know nothing else, I know that I'm not who I was. Because if you keep denying your flesh, if you keep denying your flesh, take me to the next scripture, you're going to die. He said in 1 Corinthians 5:31, he says, I die daily. The longer you starve something, you starve it to death. Do you hear what he's talking about? The longer you starve something, you starve it to death. Like, as much as I enjoy smoking, I haven't smoked in 30-some years. If I pick up a cigarette right now, I would choke. You know when you first start smoking, your head get like, I mean, it fell out with an aneurysm. Look at me. You could have been with somebody for years. But when you start pulling away and denying, you get in their presence. And how they used to touch you used to make your hair stand up. Now they touch you, be like, what that mean? I die. You're not saying nothing to me. What that mean? You when you used to see them, they used to make your heart skip. Now when you see them, you be like, what happened to you? I died. In other words, the enemy, is there anybody in the building to testify that I had some things that I died to? I had some individuals that used to have a grip on me. And some things I died to, my emotions and giving me into my feelings. Touch your neighbor, say, I die daily. Every day I get up to die some more. Right. Everybody stand to your feet. Gotta get this one. Trying. I know religious people so well. They act like they ain't got no weakness, no shortcoming, no fault. You like this with pride. I said this on Thursday. I had my photographer was at doing a party, and he was on a high rise. Him and he's on the back of the elevator. Two women got on the elevator, and they were strippers. Yeah. And there's two strippers started talking. One stripper said, girl, I got to go. I got to go to church tomorrow. The other stripper said, church. The other stripper said, yeah, church. The other stripper said, what church you go to? The other stripper said, New Life. And my photographer texted me. I said, look at God. Because if she stick with me, she not going to be in that elevator stripping no more. Because if she stay under the anointing and the Holy Ghost get a good grip on her, he going to drag her behind off a pole. How come ain't nobody giving God no glory?
God, Rebel.
He thought I was going to be embarrassed. I said, I'm not embarrassed. I said, that's a testimony. Because that let me know that although she over there, she keep coming over here. God, get me together. Send an anointing in the building that can destroy every yoke. Is there anybody that I can't stop doing it on my own? But I need the spirit of the living God. So how have I, in 33 years, there's a war between my spirit and my flesh. He said, sometimes I do what I know I ain't got no business doing, and then what I want to do, I don't do. And then Paul said, it was given to me a thorn in my flesh. I asked you to take that thing out, but you ain't take that thing. He said, but I left it there to keep you on your face. Because that's the thing that's going to keep driving you back to me. That's the thing that's going to let you be sensitive to what grace really is. So every time I come here, or every time we come together, this is why it's important that the Spirit of the Living God come in the building. Lift your hands and say, Spirit of the Living God.
Spirit of the Living God.
fall fresh on me. Would you hear me? I'm saying, when you draw out of God, He draw out of you. If I don't know nothing else, I know how to get on that altar. And I know how to call on God and to change God. I've messed up before, but I guess what? I crawl my messed up self right back on the altar. And I tell God, I'm not going nowhere. And I still believe that you're going to deliver me out of the hand of the enemy. This ain't me, God. I need your spirit. Come on, lift your hands. Say, Spirit of the living God, Spirit. Fall fresh. Oh, man. You want God to deliver you from. Come on, don't call on man, call on God. Come on, lift your hands and say, come on, Jesus, come on. Come on in, come on, come on. I'm open, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open. Come on, lift your hands, say the Lord, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open, I'm open. Look at the screen, and the spirit of him who raised Christ from the dead is living in you. He who raised Christ from the dead will also live, will give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit. You die, but he gonna give you life. Yes. I die daily, but his spirit makes me live. Because yes. The life I now live, I live in the spirit. Yes. And there's somebody under the sound of my voice. Yes. It's been a pull.
Yes.
Verse me.
Yes.
This side can't win. Some of y'all are like, you know what, forget it. I'm just going to stay over here. No, you can't stay over here. You got to get back on your fight. You got to get back on your deny. Grab your neighbor by the hand. Make sure you got a real person. Look at them say, I need help. Tell them I need the Spirit of God.
I need the Spirit of God.
See, y'all, you ain't doing nothing. You ain't drinking. You ain't smoking. You eating. You need an attitude deliverance. You find something wrong with everybody, but you can't see yourself. You self-righteous. Come on. Come on, hold the hands and say, help us, Lord, help us. Help us. I need you. I need you. Time doesn't allow me to go where I want to go in the spirit realm. But I say, everybody, every time you come in here, I watch my 7:30 doing worship. And some of y'all, I don't know what it is that you just stand there and you look at them. Worship is for you to go in. Worship is set up for you to go into the presence of God. Do you not know that you can get delivered in worship? And some of y'all, you sitting up here waiting on somebody to deliver you. You better learn how to dive in and deliver yourself. Come on, hold that hand again. Say, help us, Lord. Come on, say, help us, Lord. Now let that hand go and lift your hands and begin to cry to God for yourself. Oh, I need thee. Every hour, I need thee. I got to.
Yeah.
the Lord, I want to be totally free. Some of y'all, he wants you to be totally free. He wants you to get to the point that you've never even wanted again. That you let it become your testimony. Is there anybody in the building that already got a testimony? There's some things that you used to go back and forth, but he delivered you out of the hand of the enemy. I need to close this out, but I need to hear what that praise sounds like. I'm not gonna tell you what to give, but I want to ask everyone if you can get an extra seat in your hand, an extra seat, and all of this will be sent and made out to the school. We've already contacted the financial aid office to make sure that we as a church can send this, wire this to his account. Now watch me, I know some of y'all, well, my child going to school too.
Well,
please don't do that. Let me obey God in this area. And the Lord told me to sow into life because the devil wanted him dead. How are we going to do this? One more time, I got buckets. I have buckets on the end. Whatever you're going to, listen to me. Listen to me before you do anything. Don't give him Jesus money. Don't put your tithe and offering in that bucket. You won't give your tithe and offering on the way out. I have buckets on the end. Whatever you want to give towards this kid's tuition, can you place it in the bucket? Where the bucket's at? Let's move. Let's move quickly. She holds the bucket up. She got big money. We're moving quickly. Come on, we're moving quickly. I mean, I know he gonna live. He's gonna live. And the thing is, this is a kid. When you saw the picture, he's not in the games. It was a mistaken identity. With this kid. He's at a gas station getting gas and he jumped out. Thinking that he was somebody else. But God said, not so. God said, not so. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Lift your seat unto the Lord. Lift your seat unto the Lord. Repeat after me.